Skip it up and that up.
Hari Kondabolu is a 35-year-old American comedian from Indian descent. Now, why do I bring up his nationality? You'll find out in a second. Now, in 2017, Hari made the true TV documentary, The Problem with Apu. And he's referring to Apu Mahasapina Pantalon from The Simpsons.
I hate Apu.
Hate Apu?
Hate Apu. When? And because of that, I dislike The Simpsons.
Wow, the whole series.
Yeah.
The whole series?
Yeah.
I love The Simpsons. I just don't love that character. But the whole
I have
thing.
Never been able to divorce the two.
I love The Simpsons because...
You hate yourself.
Because I complete... this whole film is me trying to get over the fact I hate myself. How many of you were bullied in any capacity as a child?
We raising hands?
Yeah, raising hands. We'll do the hands thing. Yeah. Okay, now how many had to deal with, like, being called a poo or that being referenced?
Now, to give you the super Cliff Notes edition with The Problem with Apu, Ari basically said that you have this white voice actor, because Apu is voiced by Hank Azaria, putting on a stereotypical Indian accent of a stereotypical Indian character. Now, to give you the super Cliff Notes edition of The Problem with Apu, Hari is basically saying that you have this stereotypical Indian character who's being voiced by a white guy, because the voice of Apu is Hank Azaria, who is a stereotypical Indian man with a stereotypical job in a comedy cartoon show that has been running for 29 seasons now. And Hari said that due to such a popular character being in such a popular show and having this stereotype of Indian people in The Simpsons, he's dealt with a lot of profiling throughout his life. Now again, if you want to watch the full documentary to find out more than what I just told you, obviously go watch the True TV Problem with Apu and you'll find out more than what I just said. Now ever since he released his documentary, The Simpsons have received a lot of flack for having Apu still in the show. And it kills me because I have the clip of The Simpsons responding to all the Apu controversy right here, but if I show you a clip of The Simpsons in this video, even though it's fair use, Fox will have this video taken down and have a strike on my YouTube account before the video is even completed uploading. So I will just read you the text from this one scene from The Simpsons and tell you what they had to say about the whole Apu controversy. Now, this short little summary comes from Newsweek. I'll have a link below to the article in the description if you want to check it out. During the episode, Marge reads The Princess in the Garden to Lisa, a Simpsons take on the Frances Hodgson Burnett's The Secret Garden, but changes the identity of the book's heroine in an effort to modernize the plot, which essentially disrupts the emotional journey of the book completely. When Lisa suggests there's no point to the book with Marge's changes, her mother frustratingly asks, "Well, what am I supposed to do?" Lisa responds, "It's hard to say. Something that started decades ago and was applauded and inoffensive is now politically incorrect. What can you do?" Then you'll see the camera pan over to a picture of Apu on Lisa's nightstand and it says, "Don't have a cow." And sorry, Hari, I agree with The Simpsons and creators. Something that was started many moons ago, The Simpsons is now, God, what, over 30 years old? Now all of a sudden people feel it's okay to be offended? And of course, Twitter, the website that I love so much, had a whole bunch of people crying over this Simpsons episode, and this is what they had to say about it. The Simpsons' completely toothless response to Hari Kondabolu and The Problem with Apu about the racist character Apu. Something that started decades ago and was applauded and inoffensive is now politically correct. What can you do? Another person wrote, and I'm gonna have their names and faces blurred out for privacy reasons. The Simpsons, 1989 to 2018, rest in peace. I think the fact that they put this argument in the mouth of Lisa's character, the character who usually champions the underdogs and is supposed to be the most thoughtful and liberal, is what makes this the most ridiculous, as in worthy of ridicule, and toothless response. Now, Ari himself responded, him I will actually show his picture and face, because, well, he's the one who actually started this controversy and wants to discuss it. Wow, politically incorrect? That's the takeaway from my movie and the discussion it sparked? Man, I really love this show. This is sad. And I'll just read one more Twitter comment because they just keep going and going and going. You know how Twitter is. Something that started decades ago and was applauded and inoffensive is now politically incorrect. What can you do? Probably some white dude. P.S. No one watches The Simpsons for wholesome, politically correct animation, but having Lisa Simpson delivering this line is a big fuck you to those who criticize the Apu stereotype. This shit is what drives me nuts about society. Now, look, I am 120% against racism. I don't even understand racism and why the hell it exists. Who cares what skin color someone is? Who cares what sexual orientation someone is? I know that's not racism, that's sexism, but you get my point. It's the same damn thing. I mean, as long as it's two consenting adults, who are, whether you're attracted to men or women or whatever the case may be, if it's an adult and they're consenting, I don't care. Have at it. Have a blast. I don't understand why people waste their time on such stupid, frivolous shit. But here we are, and that's what human beings do. And yes, I know that Hank Azaria was told by the Simpsons creators to make the most offensive Indian accent possible. I saw him say it with his own mouth. I get all that.
Right away, they were like, can you do an Indian voice? And how offensive can you make it? I would immediately begun to talk this way. I was like, it's not tremendously accurate. It's a little stereotype. Like, that's all right.
But my thing is this. One, comedy always pushes limits. I know Hari's argument is that there's only one Indian person in the show, and the other stereotypes is of multiple different kinds of white people. But Hari, I know you say you're not trying to be a snowflake, but don't you think you are kind of being a snowflake when there's a bunch of other really strong stereotypes in The Simpsons that could offend other people too? What about Waylon Smithers? He is a stereotypical closeted homosexual. Don't you think that may offend the gay community? What about Groundskeeper Willie? He's a stereotypical Scotsman to the nth degree. Should Scottish people be offended? What about Reverend Lovejoy, the stereotypical Christian who basically hates other religions? Should people be offended? Should Christians be offended by Reverend Lovejoy? But what about law enforcement throughout the world and throughout the nation? What about Chief Wiggum, who is the stereotypical donut-eating, fat, lazy cop? Should law enforcement, should police be offended by Chief Wiggum? Because here's the thing. I get you're saying, oh, there's only one Indian person in The Simpsons. If we have to attack one stereotype and get rid of Apu, then we have to get rid of all the stereotypes. And at that point, you may as well just well say comedy shouldn't exist, because comedy always pushes limits. I mean, for Christ's sake, look at Family Guy. It takes a lot to make me cringe, and there's some stuff on Family Guy, which I don't really watch Family Guy that much anymore. I just got kind of bored of it, but you get my point. There are things in Family Guy I'm like, damn, man, you are pushing it. But that's comedy. That's what comedy does. You're a comedian, supposedly. Don't you understand that? Don't you get how that goes? Don't you think that those stereotypes, which I apologize for people stereotyping you, but if Apu didn't exist, you're an Indian American, don't you think that people would stereotype you in a different way because people are shitty? Really, you're going to put this all on Apu because there's a popular Indian character on a very, very famous cartoon comedy show? Here's what happens. When you start going after frivolous crap like this, like a character Apu on The Simpsons, what happens is that it's censorship, basically. And you're going down this dangerous route of where people are going to be afraid to try and do anything because they're going to be afraid they're going to have some kind of consequence to it. Look at that Count Dacula who was on YouTube who had his dog do a Nazi salute. And now he may be facing prison time. Prison time over a parody where he had his pug do a Nazi salute. And he may be going to jail because of it. Where the hell are we going, man? What the hell is going on? And this is the thing. Once people get offended and find something wrong, then people take it a step further. And people take it a step further. And it's used for censorship. And it's used to hinder free speech. So you're politically correcting yourselves into fascism, whether you're smart enough to realize it or not. One of the great things about comedy is that it pushes limits. It makes you feel uncomfortable. It makes you look in the mirror. And if you try to defend comedy, then what's the point of comedy? And if you can't handle a fictional character like Apu, unplug your computer and get the fuck off the internet. This is Rich of ReviewTechUSA signing out. Have a good one. And shut off your TV too. Just some advice.